Welcome to part 3 of Building IBIS AMI Models for High-Speed SERDES Devices. My name is Sanjeev Gupta. I am Signal Integrity Applications Specialist with Agilent Technologies East of EDA Division. Coming back to system view design environment, there are numerous ways to represent your PCI Express Gen 2 transmitter. In my previous design, I have used a blind feed-forward equalizer to demonstrate how we can create two-tab DM phases. User can also take discrete component such as the variable gain component, the amplifier adder component to create two-tab DM phases. Moving to PCI Express Gen 3 specifications, Gen 3 requires three-tab transmit DM phases. The tap coefficients are defined as part of PCI Express Gen 3 specifications. Let us see how we can create a PCI Express Gen 3 transmit topologies. Here we are taking the filter tap coefficients and mapping those tap coefficients to a bank of filter. All these signals are combined using a multiplexer component at the output, and the right data path is selected based on the user provided parameter value. Instead of using S-domain filter at the output to shape the waveform, this design uses a time response FIR filter. The time response FIR filter allows us to include any SPICE simulated or major data as part of SERDES representation. Both the step response or the impulse response data can be mapped to this device as real array. This component allows resampling of the data during IBIS AMI simulation. The last example I wanted to include in this presentation is the full channel simulation of a serial link working at 6.25 gigabit per second. The serial link has the transmitter and receiver AMI model and S parameter based Tycho channel. The transmitter model is very much similar to what we have seen earlier. It uses a time response FIR filter to bring in measured step response for the SERDES device, a gain block, and a blind feedforward equalizer to represent transmit equalization. The receiver AMI model is a combination of CTLE, which is continuous time linear equalizer, a CDR component, and the blind DFE component. We have seen wide varieties of SERDES components so far, such as S-domain filter, blind feedforward equalizer, decision feedback equalizer, CDR circuit. In addition, there are many more components such as regular DFE, FFE, subcomponent which is used to create CDR such as voltage control oscillators, different kind of phase detector, etc. All these components can be synthesized into C++ for AMI model generation. Coming back to the original design, in this design, we are collecting the data at the output of AMI transmitter, at the output of channel, after CTLE, and after DFE. We are taking these four data streams and sending it to FlexDCA to compare eye diagram performance. Let us try now to run the system level simulation of this serial link. This is the signal after the decision feedback equalizer and is obvious from the discontinuities at the crossing points. I'm going back and activating the signal at the transmitter. As you can see, at the transmitter we have a very clean signal with some type of equalization coming due to the feed forward equalizer. The signal after the receiver shows eye diagram is almost close. Here we see the signal after the continuous time linear equalizer. It helps us to open eye diagram and to recover the signal. And for the DFE, we have already seen the case how the eye diagram looks like. Now we have simulated this system, and we can go back and generate the IBIS AMI model for the transmitter and receiver device. To generate C++ code for transmitter and receiver, I select C++ code generation option. Here we can select and map different component, transmit and receive component, for which we want to generate C++ code. From the pull down menu, we selected the IBIS algorithmic modeling interface. For every component in the list, we select the parameters such as the model type and if it is transmit or receive design, map the AMI init argument and generate C code. The C code is exported. A Visual Studio project is created. To build AMI model, I can go here and build solution. What we have seen so far is the fully automated flow to generate AMI model for your transmit and receive SERDES device. I hope we provided you enough information in this presentation to visualize how you can automate IBIS AMI SERDES modeling flow within your organization. Here I am summarizing the benefit of using System View for IBIS AMI modeling flow. It provides you basic building blocks to create SERDES representation, which include FIR, IIR filter, feed forward and decision feedback equalizer, and CDR circuit. You can include measured or SPICE simulated data as part of SERDES AMI representation. Inbuilt model can be customized, or custom C++ code can be included as part of your design. You can also include M code. System View completely automates C++ code generation process and compilation. Design environment is easy to use. System View provides links with measurement instruments such as Flex DCA, where it allows you to perform exhaustive post-processing on simulated signal for waveform, for eye diagram, and you can also perform jitter analysis. It also helps in validating your design against lab measurements. To evaluate this product, you can receive demo code word by going to esof.com website or by contacting your local sales representative.